Hey, what's up guys, this is Daddy Cool and you are watching Satisfactory with the subtitle Megafactory Online. Now, if you haven't watched the first episode, the reason for this subtitle is that by the end of this playthrough I would like to create a huge Megafactory where I will be able to produce the endgame products for the space elevator. Compared to the previous episode, there are a couple of changes. I have built an iron ore extraction point that is creating iron plates. During the previous episode I have created a production line into here that is producing biomass fuel for my energy producers there. There was an efficiency upgrade in copper production in here, and I have also created limestone production, which is in the background. We cannot see it from here. So these are the things that happened in previous episodes, and during this episode my plan is to create the space elevator. Finally, I think I have all the products necessary for that, and of course also unlock some new things. And let's just check these things in here. The jump pad. Not interesting. Resourcing bonus, not interesting, but the logistics MK2 is very interesting for me at the moment. I'm gonna need the conveyor belt MK2, I will unlock the conveyor belt MK2, which is very good because it has a double efficiency regarding transport, unit transportation, 120 pieces. That's really good to create things even more efficient. And let's just select this milestone. Well, there is one thing that is present here. I need 50 pieces of reinforced iron plates, and I just don't want to do that by hand. So basically I could, and I think, yeah, I have all the necessary materials for that, but this is not gonna happen. I wanna create an automated factory for that. And let's check what are the requirements to do so. It's the assembler, and I need 4 rotors and 8 reinforced iron plates. So let's create those things. I have now everything in hand. So 4 rotors and 8 reinforced iron plates, that's the very minimum to create such a thing. 5, 6, 7, 8, there we go. And I am planning to put this machine next to the storage places and feed it from there. I think one such a machine is gonna be enough for now. You're gonna produce reinforced iron plates, and that's the iron plate source, that's the screw source, and give it some power. There you go. And also I wanna put the finished product into this storage place. That's it. Okay, now as you can see, the conveyor belts are starting to overlap each other, and I hope during this episode I will be able to solve this issue. We will see how far I can get. The next thing I would like to do is to put the wood and leaves into the storage containers, and we have an issue here. Something is just not good. Okay, I had an inappropriate thing in the storage container. Let's replace this thing here. Now it's fine. I'm gonna put the leaves there as well. There you go. I have, yeah, it's a solid biofuel, not wood. Okay, and this means I can feed my producers here once again. Okay, we have a system shutdown, and the reason is that I am not producing enough energy. So let's just build maybe 3 more pieces of energy production. 2 and 1 more. 3, okay. That will hopefully fulfill the request. There you go. Energy goes to everywhere. I had some biofuel there, wait, biomass. Now it's working. And the thing I would like to do now is I do not want to feed these places by hand. So let's put the splitter into 5, merger 6. And one splitter goes here, another one goes here, and another one goes in here. So feed that one from there. That is gonna be feeded from there. That one from there. You come to this. It's not that hard to create this chaos here. Actually, it's a very big chaos ruling in this area, but more or less it's organized at the moment. So what are you using? Nothing. But once the lines are filled properly, those burners will be feeded automatically from now on. Okay, let's put this thing there. Oh, wrong button. Didn't want to do that. But basically, maybe I was. So let's put everything else into the hub. I'm gonna need the iron rods and the reinforced iron plates, which are under production. But that's okay. Sort, put those things into the storage, maybe those things as well. So the next thing I would like to do is harvest some more biofuel, and hopefully I will be able to find some new things, just like I did in the previous episode, that can be researched and hopefully unlock some new possibilities for building and doing things. Wow, there are some birds in there. A fauna is growing? I don't think so. Okay, I will go behind that huge tree just as last time and gonna harvest things there. That seems to be a good idea for me. Yeah, let's cut this tree. Okay. I'm gonna harvest this tree on this island. And there we go. Something is in there in the background. I want to check that thing for sure. Pick this fruit. Got this thing. Well, this chainsaw is is a miracle compared to picking up things by hand. I really like it. Area clear is very beneficial, very useful. Let's cut these things out. Yeah. And let's get closer to that location. Here is another plant. Okay, let's cut this tree. Oh, hello, buddy. Okay. Where's your hide? Let's clear things a bit. Did I pick it up? Spritter remains. Yeah. It seems so. So clear this area just a little bit. Yeah. I can pick up that wire, that's good. We still have some inventory space. And let's check this thing. I don't think there is too much thing I can do here. Maybe there are some parts in here. Okay, iron rod, that's good. Whoa, iron plates. These are the things I was looking for. And some concrete. Oops. We are being attacked by the spore splitter. How should I call that? Yeah, place is cleared. What's that? It's just the wood. Oh, everything is full of spores. I do not have more space in the inventory. But I wanna check this thing. It was okay. Repairs needed. Needs electricity. Okay, let's mark this on the map, I think. Put a marker like this here. I was attacked once again. I just cannot get close enough to that plant. And what's this? Ooh, rotors. Very good. My icon has changed. Yeah, that's good. Okay, let's change it back to the yellow marker. So I'm gonna drop something here. I'm not sure. Copper ore, yeah, you can go. I wanna take that rotors for sure. Where were you? Here you go. Okay, let's swim into that direction, and I suppose it's time to go back to the hub. Yeah, this was a good trip once again. A couple of useful resources in hand. Can I get those fruits? I suppose, yeah, there you go. And let's use this conveyor for a little bit faster walk. Up, two, three, four. Up, two, three, four. Okay. Let's put the things into the storage. And I think I know what I will do with the rotors and the plates. First of all, fill the storage. Yeah, take the resources out. I have inventory issue, but I know how to solve this. Let's sort, put things here, and this will solve the issue I just had. And this one is wood, okay. Let's put the leaves in there too. There you go. And I have to feed these biomass burners by hand, but that's not a big deal. Okay, this one goes in. This one goes in. Sort. Nice. I'm gonna take the finished products out. Okay, that's great. Let's fill these. And I'm not gonna put the reinforced iron plates there, because I wanna create an assembler here, and this is not gonna be feeded at all. I need only energy for that. And I'm gonna create smart plating here, and the reason is that the space elevator only accepts produced things, and I cannot create them by hand, only through machinery. And just because this is the first thing, I am pretty sure I will need this thing for the space elevator to be fitted, so it's a good idea to start it just right now. And it takes 30 seconds to produce one, so this will take a while the machine is playing with the ingredients I just gave him. Okay, let's collect the remaining things from here. Okay, how many reinforced iron plates do I have? 45, very nice. I'm gonna put that into the producer machine again. Yeah, rotors, reinforced plates. Let's put them there. Okay, what's next, you may ask? I think it's time to look for another iron source, so let's check. Ooh, it's a little bit further away. I'm gonna choose that one because I wanna create more iron rods and maybe even screws. Iron plate is more or less okay at the moment, but I am pretty sure sooner or later I have to tend that production as well. And I almost forget to take electricity with me, just to not make a trip there and back once again. There you go. We have a food here and something to mine. I'm gonna check that very shortly. Oh, and here we go. There's the iron. It was not that far. Let's pick it up. Mine this. Catering ore. Okay. And let's check the quality of this ore. Take that food. Okay, and the thing I would like to build here is the iron ore mine, like that. So the production speed is 120 pieces. Well, that's actually good, and lucky for me, I cannot really take all of the products it is generating, because my conveyor belt handles only 60 pieces. And so I can only take half of the things it is generating. And I think I take the resource and not process it here for now. So let's, I want to make this a little bit nicer, like that. Let's bring things home. That's the maximum. Okay, one more segment. And I'm gonna process the things, the resources near my base this time. We have a nice long spaghetti going on. And let's start things here. So I will take 60 pieces of ores, which means I need only two smelters. One goes there, one goes there. Let's feed them. And I will need a splitter for that. Like that. No, that's a merger. The splitter. Yeah. Do I have to come here? Yeah. I do not see the resource coming. Oh, it is. It's just a little bit slower. And I will create the constructor. Yeah. I have to take reinforced iron plates to do so. Let's collect them. So I wanna do there only iron rod production. This is the one. Oops, could not jump high enough. And the thing is that I think this storage is empty. Yeah, because the assembler takes all the screws that I am producing at the moment, which is not really good. I mean, in terms of screw stock, I do not have any screws left and not producing any for later use. But I have an iron rod producer here, so what I'm gonna do is take this thing out from here, put the constructor into here, like that. And this is gonna be a screw producer. And connect it there. I am missing electricity only, but I do not see any free pole for that. Not there. Come on. Let's just put it here. Someone has to be able to be connected. Come on. You? No. No one? Okay, let's do it in a different approach. There you go. And hopefully this is working. Yeah, iron rod go there. Screw door go there. That's nice. It's pretty dark. I hope you see just like I do, because I see everything. It's enough light for me, but later I will also create some lights to be able to better see things in the evening and in the night. So we have the smelters there, which are not set to smelt just yet. Maybe I should do that. Smelt ingots, smelt ingots. Oh, and I do not have electricity yet in hand, but okay, that will be also solved. So I'm gonna make here production constructors, and these will be iron rod producers. But before that, I think that's not a good thing there. I do not have or do I? Yeah, smelters create ingots, so I can place 4 constructors here like that. Okay, so I need a splitter here. I mean 2 splitters. Splitter 1, splitter 2. So you go there, you go there, and not there. Misclick. And that one goes there, you feed there, and you feed there. Okay, let's give some energy for this area. Connect things like that. Machine 1, machine 2. Machine 1, machine 2, and there, and there. Okay. So now things should be going. What's the problem? You don't have iron ore. Actually, you have iron ore. Why are we not working? No power. Oh. Oh, oh, oh. But come on, I'm on the line. No. There we go. Now it's working. That's good. So the next thing is mergers. I wanna collect everything that comes from these machines into here and here and here, and let's place a storage like that. Not the nicest solution. Come on. was good.
Yeah.
Still not okay. Oh. Deconstruct. Do it once more. With a different angle. Storage. Like that. Now it's okay. So you go into there. What's invalid conveyor ship? Oh, come on. It can be real. Let's check the other one. Goes. Connect. 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 And we are missing only this area. Have to be working. Let's do it like this. Okay. Problem solved. And set these things to iron rods. Okay. Now, normally, this should be a good setup. I mean, there's the ore. There are the ingots, there goes the rods, and finally they arrive into the storage. That's good. I am missing rotors, and I have some smart platings, but the rotors can wait just a little bit. Let's feed the remaining parts there. And collect things from the production area. I hope I have enough reinforced iron plates ready. That's the concrete. Yeah, almost. I need 10 more pieces. I think I'm gonna build those 10 pieces by hand. So these are all the resources that I have, which I have just gathered. Everything is running smoothly, that's good. Let's create 10 pieces of reinforced iron plates. I have to have 41 pieces in hand, that's the point. 38, 9. 40, 41. Let's put it there and launch.
Milestone reached. Fixit would like to remind you of your contractual obligation towards efficiency. Recreational use of belts and lifts does not count towards work hours and will put you on the list. Stay efficient, don't disappoint Fixit.
Okay, let's check if I can build a space elevator. That's the next thing. 40 pieces of iron rods are missing. Rest of the goods is in hand. And there you go. It was worth to build that factory part. And I'm gonna hop on this rock. No, I'm not gonna do that. Maybe from here, yeah. I wanna go into the high ground. So as you can see, we have a huge area in here. And I'm gonna place the space elevator into this area, this location. And I'm gonna put to here some kind of an organized production site. So that's the plan. And yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So let's start with the space elevator. Oh, it's huge. Gonna put it there. A lot of resources are going in, flowing in. That's good. It's very similar to Factorio. Okay. It's opening. Oh, we have something there in the sky. Oh, now I see. So this is an accepting part for a real space elevator. That's cool. I mean, it's really cool. Wonderful job, designers. You made it really nice.
Project assembly initialized. Congratulations, Pioneer. The space elevator will now automatically connect with the Project Assembly orbital platform. Project Assembly is divided into phases, each of which require the delivery of project parts, such as smart plating, via the space elevator. Subsequent phases unlock access to new tiers with more advanced technologies to construct, automate, explore, and exploit. It is time to be honest. This project is part of the Save the Day program, the largest united undertaking in human history, destined to save us all. Earth is in peril and only Fixit pioneers offer hope for survival. Fixit is counting on you. Humanity is counting on you. Do not let Fixit down.
Okay, so our job is to feed Earth in general. So what's the phase one distribution? Plan. Okay, I was right. We need smart plating and 50 pieces. Well, those 50 pieces I think I can actually reach. I just need a couple of rotors because I have the reinforced iron plates. And if I am correct, let's just check the quantity. Yeah, 25 in hand, 25 pieces of rotors. I think I can do that. So, rotors, or maybe not. But I am only missing probably the iron rods. Yeah, it's not a big deal to collect those. I already have a pretty nice automated things for that. Let's collect it and on the... In the meantime, the assembler is working. There you go. Now we are producing some quantities. So, rotor. Did I take 9 pieces? I suppose. So, this means I will do all the rotors I can. Probably the screw is the bottleneck of this thing. Let's create, yeah, all of them that I can. There you go. Put it there. Yeah, that's okay. Collect these. And while it's working and creating things there, let's check what I can do in here. I have one of these in the storage and also the Caterium in hand. I have this one as well in the storage. Okay, let's collect things. So Caterium I have, this one I have. Let's grab everything and I'm gonna put these wires there, get these things, put the cables, I have plenty of cables, these things, and let's check what I can research in here. let's the hatcher research.
The remains researched belong to a plant-like organism hosting the larva of the flying crab, the most mature of which hatch when threatened. Hatcher remains can now be made into alien protein, and additional research may reveal options for improving pioneer safety during exploration.
Okay, alien technology. I do not have that. I have this, so let's research this.
Summersloop analysis completed. Summersloops are somewhere between battery and conduit, harvesting energy from pockets of space with complete disregard for the rules of the space-time continuum, and distributing it into its connected ecosystem. This energy...
Let the effigies harvest until the waves reach our shores. Consume.
Similarities to the hypothetical force of dark energy to potentially be one and the same. It can now be tracked by the object scanner.
Okay, we can search for that thing, this means. Let's create this one as well. I have the necessary materials.
Research completed. Caterium ingot recipe unlocked. New caterium research available.
Mm-hmm. Now I can create caterium from the resource. Okay. Mycelia.
The mycelial networks of these fungi possess unusually resilient hyphae, which show potential for making a strong but lightweight natural fabric. Additionally, it has similar medicinal and pest control applications to mycelia on Earth.
Okay, I think that's 100 pieces of biomass is there. Yeah, let's just collect that. Yeah, I was correct. Start this research as well.
Research completed. Fabric recipe unlocked. New mycelia research available.
Okay, another product that I can create, and I will be able to unlock the parachute. That's good. More safer travel means. Power slug is done. I have to look for yellow power slug. Okay. I do not have enough quartz. I do not have enough quartz here neither. And what here? Not really be able to create those things just yet. Okay, I think that's all for the unlock. Here, this goes here. Check these burners. Okay, store things into the storage just really fast. There you go, there you go. Okay, what's that bauxite? Yeah, you can go there. Iron ore, I do not need, just take space. Sort. I have some coal in hand. That's good. I hope this is finished. No. I still need 14 pieces. Yeah, just as I thought, it's not the fastest process of them all. I think let's check in the meantime the other iron source. It was... yeah, that way. In the very distance. That's copper, so I was not looking for this. And 200 and roughly 200 meters that way. Come on, just die. Check it once more. There we go. Okay. Fight this creature as well. That. No, I want to pick up the remains. Okay. And this one is impure. Okay, which means if I put miner here, this will show 30 units per minute. Well, I think we have to live with this. I wanna put a smelter right next to it. Yeah, change you into Ignot. Let's take the resource here. And I was missing the electricity. Just bind them together like that. This one goes there. Oh, there you go. That was the sound while I was coming to here. One enemy down. Let's check the other one. Second enemy down. And there's a power slug in here. Okay. Okie dokie. Let's collect the energy. Yeah, it's easier if you take the energy with you when you are going there, but which way I am going? Like that. And go that way. Yeah, it's okay. Transportation comes here. And just go forward into here. And once again into here. No, did not succeed with the positioning. Yeah. Energy. Set here. And how can I put this into the system? There is no free point at all, usually. There we go. That's an exception. So what should I do from the iron I am receiving? That's a good question. I think I will create screws maybe. It's 40 units per minute. That's not a really good idea actually. Let's create some iron plates. That's okay. So I have a smelter there. I am missing reinforced iron plates again. That one is taken. Constructor here. And just a simple storage here. That's not a big quantity that this thing will produce. There we go, the ore is coming on the way. And set this into, yeah, iron plates. So let's check the thing for the space elevator. really fast, and after that we will see what I can still do in this episode. One more piece, I'm gonna wait that. Well, it takes 30 seconds to produce one, so that's not the fastest thing in the universe, I can say. But it was a good idea to place this machine in the beginning of this episode, I suppose. There you go, 50 pieces. Still very, very nice, magnificent structure here. So let's feed this there. Seal.
Welcome to the Project Assembly Pioneer Progress Presentation. Congratulations, the Phase 1 project part shipment is now ready for delivery. On delivery, Phase 1 will be completed and the distribution platform will be constructed. After completion of Phase 1, the technologies of Tiers 3 and 4 will become available in the hub. Highlights are automated power, steel production, personnel transportation, and many more. Completing Phase 2 of Project Assembly is your next main objective. New project parts will need to be produced and delivered to the space elevator as you have done previously. Continue to construct, automate, explore and exploit for a better fix-it future.
And sent. Okay. That's pretty cool.
Phase 1 of Project Assembly completed. This is only the beginning of Project Assembly, the first step towards saving the day. You have performed adequately so far. Reminder, not only is Fix-It saving humanity, it is saving all of Earth, including kittens and puppies. It is statistically likely that you appreciate the continued existence of kittens and or puppies. Continue the work for their sake. Continue the work for Fix-It. It is time to start the work on Phase 2 of Project Assembly.
Ooh, okay. A couple of more things here to create. 1,000 pieces of smart plating, okay. That seems to be a lot of work to do. But that's the game about, so it's not a big problem. I like challenges, and we will be able to create everything, I suppose, properly. So let's check what we do have in here. I mean, I think I unlocked, yeah, tier 3 and 4. What are the future things? Coal power, oh yeah. That's some stable source of energy. It's very good. Vehicle, transport, tractor, tractor station, basic steel production, foundry, steeling nut, and so on. Xenobasher, some personal protection. Oh yeah, and the blueprints. Build gun upgrade, blueprints, very good, logistics MK3. I see we are needing steel beams for this. Steel beams here and modular frame there. Power storage, that's good. And the hyper tube, That's also really good. I mean, okay, probably coal power will be the first priority now, and after that I'm gonna unlock everything else that can be found in here. So first of all, coal power. That's the thing for the next episode, I suppose. Let's put these things into the storage. And I'm gonna collect the resources in the meantime. So let's collect the iron plates. No, it's the concrete first. Reinforced iron plates also for a couple of buildings. Iron plates, oh, that's good. Really, a lot of pieces there. Screw is empty. I mean, in this one, it's okay. Some more iron plates gathering in that storage as well. So it seems that this production part, this production line is working nicely already. So let's go and check what have we done in this episode. So that's very nice. I am really happy about this building. We have built the space elevator and have just started to create a couple of useful things for taking the story forward. There is a small production area for iron rods in there. That's really good. Automated feeding system for the energy production. I am really happy about that as well. And basically, yeah, another iron source in that background area. So basically we are going forward step by step, and I think that's the end of this episode, guys. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content and feel like, just hit the like and or the subscribe button, and see you next time in the next episode. Goodbye.